Hello friends, in the next two video I am going to discuss about category, because we have been doing every work on the product but nothing has been done for the category. So what I want is for our project that if the admin wants to add a new product and he wants to add a category, I am going to display a button just below this category drop down so that a model dialog box will be opened and the admin can fill up a new category and the category will get displayed here. And this entire operation will be done only for the new product and not while the admin is going to edit the product. So let us see how we can achieve the same. The first step, we are going to add a new button that will target a model dialog box. So we are going to design that button just below that category drop down. So I'm going to open our manage product .jsp file, and inside this form, just below the category, that is after this select, I'm going to write a simple C if, and I'm going to test that if the product dot ID is equal to 0, then only display that button. Now for button, before adding button I will add a break to add some space, and then I'm going to add a button. The type will be button only, but we need to specify two important attributes for button, that is the data toggle. So what we want to display, we want to display the model dialog box and the data target. So this target is going to be the ID for our model dialog box. I'm going to write it as my category modal. Along with this, I'm gonna add few of the Bootstrap classes. So I'm gonna write class equal to btn warning, and also I'm gonna make it at btn sm, so we can get a small button. So after adding this code, let us see whether we are able to see that button or not. So you can see we are able to see that button, but I don't want this button to be displayed here. I want this button to be displayed here. So how can we achieve the same thing? And we are also going to reduce the size of that button. I'm gonna make it extra small, and let us add this entire code inside a div, and I'm gonna assign a class of textWrite, which is a Bootstrap class once again. And this entire code is going to get wrapped inside a div. So this div is only visible when the product ID is 0. After saving it and Ctrl F5, you can see we have our add category button here. But on the click of this add category, that model dialog box should be opened. So right now we have not created that model dialog box. So we're gonna create that model dialogs in the second step. So I have written some of the classes that we are going to use to create our model dialog box. So we have a top layer model class, and inside that we have a model dialog. That model dialog will have model content, and then model header, and then model body. So inside this model body we are going to create our spring form. But let us first code that model dialog box. I'm just gonna close this row, even I'm gonna close this row, because you can add it anywhere. That is going to be only visible only when we are going to click that button. So I'm going to write div class of model, and to give it a nice little effect of fading, I'm going to add a class of fade also, and the important thing is ID. So I've given an ID of my category model because that button is targeting this particular div using that ID. That's why we have written hash my category model in that button as a data target. This ID is going to match with that one. And then I'm gonna specify it as a role. So the role of this div is of a dialog box. After adding that div, I'm gonna add a div once again. The class would be modal dialog, and the role would be of document, which will consist of a document. Now we're gonna add another class of modal content, inside this modal content I'm gonna add a modal header. So let us add another div with a class of, it is not modal, it is modal. So I'm gonna add modal header. Now this modal header will have a button. Okay. The type of would be button only. And inside this we are going to specify a class of close. So this is going to be our close button, and we are going to say data dismiss equal to modal. Inside this I am going to add a span to display some value. So that is going to be our x symbol using ampersand times. So it is going to dismiss that modal dialog box. We are applying a class of close and it will show an x symbol. Now after adding that button, I am going to add h4 level of heading, and I am going to say add new category. Also we are going to add a class of modal title. One more thing, here inside our this modal we should not get any tabbing facilities. That's why the tab index is going to be -1. After adding the header for our modal dialog, that is this modal header, I'm gonna add a div class of modal body. So inside this modal body I am going to create a category form. So this category form is going to be our spring form. So let us first see whether we are able to display this category modal dialog box to add a new category. Just gonna do a control F5 once again to refresh, and if I click on add category, you can see that modal dialog box is visible with this X symbol. So if I click on X, modal dialog box is just dismissed. You can also dismiss it by pressing the escape key. Now our job is to add that spring form in that modal body. So for adding a spring form we are gonna use sf colon form, because if you have noticed from my previous video I already have a spring form tags available here. So I'm gonna use sf colon form. The modal attribute is going to be category. So we require a modal with the name of category. Okay. And I'm gonna add an action to it. So action would be $contextRoot. So this is going to be our mapping where we are going to post this category. So I'm going to write manage. We are going to take help of our management control only to create this mapping, and I'm going to say manage category. After this I'm going to also specify the method. So method is going to be post. I'm going to close this spring form. Now again this form will have some of the bootstrap classes, so I'm gonna add class of form horizontal. Okay. After adding that particular class, I'm gonna use our bootstrap classes once again. Div class of form group. Add a label. This would be for the name of the category. Class would be control label. Call MD4. I'm gonna say category name. Again, add a div. The class of call MD8. So 4 + 8 = 12. Gonna add our sf colon input type equal to text. will be equal to the field name in our category.java. So let me open our category.java. So the field name, you can see it is name. Okay. So the path will be name. Let us add the class of form control. This type of form group we require for description also. So let us add for description category description. Instead of input, we are going to use text area. I'm going to close it. Path would be description. I'm also going to add an ID which I have not added for previous one. Also call it as category underscore name. We are not going to call it name because we already have an ID with name for our product management form. So here it will, we are going to say it is for category underscore name because the important attribute is this path. I'm going to say it is for category description. For category description, we don't have to specify type text for text area. Instead we can specify calls equal to, and we can also specify rows equal to. So say I want to specify rows of 5. The next form group is going to be create for add category, that is the submit button. So instead of SF text area, we are going to remove this label. We are going to say call MD offset. So 4 plus 8 12, and here I am going to add a submit button. So input type equal to submit, value equal to add category, class equal to btn. I am going to add btn primary. So this completes the creation of our form. That's what we wanted to do in our third step, creating a spring form. Now for our product management form, we need to add a model attribute for that category also. So that will get linked to our model dialog box, which is having our category form. So here inside our management controller, we are going to add another model attribute for our model dialog box, and we are going to name it as category, which should be the same as the name we have assigned for this model attribute, that is category. I'm going to save it. We are going to return a public category, get category. We are going to return a blank new category. So after making these changes in our management controller, we are going to also add a request mapping to handle the post, the submission of our category details. Okay. So we have kept it as manage category, and the method is going to be post. So I'm gonna add another request mapping to handle category submission. So here I'm gonna write @ request mapping. The value is equal to slash category. Method is going to be request method. Public, we are going to return a string. Basically we are going to redirect it to the same page of manage products, handle category submission. submission. This is what I have written in my fifth step, that we are going to handle that form submission of category. That's what I'm doing it. Now here you're going to specify the model attribute. Since our model attribute name is same as that one, so I'm gonna keep it as category only. Control shift O to add model attribute. And then here we are going to use the category DO to add that category. So I'm gonna simply write category DO dot add that category. Add the new category. I'm gonna say return redirect to manage slash products slash, and here we are going to specify that query string. So the query string is operation products operation equal to perform an operation on category. So it is going to redirect to our manage slash products, which is on top here, and we will have a request param with that operation. So we have written here, if operation is not equal to null, then we are checking whether it is equal for product. If it is equal for product, then we are sending a message that product submitted successfully. So here also we are going to write another else if operation dot equals to category. So if it is the case, we are going to add the same object here, but instead of product submitted successfully, we are going to say category submitted successfully. So it was only two lines of code here in our post method for category, managing the category, that is adding the category and redirecting it to manage products along with our query string of operation, the value of category. So after making these changes, I'm gonna restart my server. So after restarting the server and refreshing my page, I'm getting this product management form once again without any error. Now if I click on this add category, I can see this add new category dialog box, model dialog box, and I can add a new category name. So let's say I'm adding a headphones category. This category is for all the headphones, and if I click on add category, you can see here the message category submitted successfully. It will go away, and if I click on this drop down box, you can see we have a headphones here. So this way you can add a new category, and then you can add a product inside that particular product management form by adding a new category. So we have successfully tested and written the code for our model dialog box, and we are also able to add a new category inside the database. Now in the next video, I'm gonna show you how you can use the jQuery validator for client-side validation, because I've already covered server-side validation. You can find the video on server-side validation on the link given in this video, and then in the next I'm gonna cover this client-side validation for jQuery validator for our category addition. Thanks for watching.